RCADE helps the Army as they navigate a number of daunting tasks. One of those tasks is to identify the capabilities required to have overmatch against potential adversaries in the future. And that time frame they're looking at is 2030 to 2050. And so that's a pretty opaque space. And RCADE helps the Army navigate that space and in identifying those capabilities. And so they find the balance really by in between getting the right capabilities, whether they're perfect or good enough or completely wrong. Right? That's the spectrum. And RCADE helps get it closer to perfect by helping evaluate a range of data and scenarios. And that in and of itself gets the solutions or potential solutions close enough to perfect. And that's what really what our nation expects of the Army. And so RCADE takes the findings, provides them to the Army. The Army uses that with all hosts of other capabilities that they have, and collaboratively and collectively, it provides a more holistic picture that provides guideposts for Army leaders to make the most informed decisions possible. RCADE entered into the equation with the Army and Army Futures Command really is a dialogue of just exploring possibilities to help the Army. Army Futures Command, or AFC for short, has the mandate to transform the Army to ensure future warfighting readiness. AFC does this by framing the toughest challenges and identifying the best solutions for our soldiers and our nation. RCADE, as a modeling and simulation tool, allows for rapid iteration of various turns within a modeling and simulation scenario. And this allows the Army at speed to get closer again to the necessary capabilities that are going to make the difference in that 2030 to 2050 timeframe. As a trusted partner and collaborator with the United States Army, RCADE was introduced not to supplant or replace anything that the Army is doing, but rather to augment and buttress what the Army was already doing with their capabilities so that they could get to a more holistic solution when looking at capabilities in 2030 to 2050 timeframe. The specific value of RCADE is it assists Army Futures Command as they are looking at a world of what ifs, right? And so RCADE helps them start from a place that's a lot closer to the potential best solution. The analogy I'll use is, would you rather boil the ocean or a 12-gallon bucket of water? And so what RCADE does, along with the Army's already existing modeling and simulation capabilities, is it helps the Army shrink that ocean down to the 12-gallon bucket so they can focus on those things that are most important and are gonna make the biggest impact in the 2030 to 2050 timeframe. RCADE is different from previous analysis, modeling and simulation in particular, that the Army and by extension the Department of Defense has been able to conduct. RCADE does this in really two fundamental ways, and that's through speed. That's the speed of iteration of the various turns within the modeling and simulation, and then also in revealing integrated solutions so that the Army can see those a little more clearly for 2030 to 2050. Additionally, the quantitative data and analysis that RCADE provides Army senior leaders allows them to do two critical things: understand decision trade space and the risk associated with those decisions. Furthermore, with RCADE, we assist the Army in understanding what an integrated solution might look like in terms of future capabilities. Lastly, RCADE assists Army Futures Command, or AFC, with understanding the holistic impact of any particular capability that they may be considering. The Army has a term called DOTMIL-PF, and that's an acronym that stands for Doctrine, Organization, Training, Material, Leadership, Personnel, and Facilities. And by understanding the impact of each of those and interrelated with the capabilities that they're bringing forward, it gives the Army a more holistic picture when they're making those various decisions.